In this video, we will go through the basics of the Thea for SketchUp user interface. Thea for SketchUp can be accessed through the following places. The first one is from the main menu under Extensions, Thea Render. The other one is by using the Thea Toolbar. If the Thea Toolbar is not active, you can either click on Show Thea for SketchUp Toolbar or right-click and select Thea for SketchUp from the context menu. The Thea Toolbar provides access to every Thea for SketchUp tool. Let's have a look at them. The first icon opens the Thea Tools panel, which consists of 5 tabs. The Camera tab has options for setting up the final resolution of the rendered image and camera properties like lens parameters, depth of field, and more. The Model tab has all the options for groups and components like visibility, beveling, and proxy creation. The Material tab includes the Material Editor that can be used in 2 modes: as a preset editor for quick material setup, or the Advanced Material Editor, which uses a layer-based approach, making it possible to create complex materials in a practical way. The Lights tab allows you to create and edit Thea lights like point lights, spotlights, IES, and projector lights. Finally, we have the Environment tab with options for physical sky, image-based lighting, and tools that makes it easy to match the sun of an EXR or HDR image to the Thea sun. In this tab, it is also possible to add fog in a scene. The next icon on the toolbar opens the settings panel, which is normally located to the right side of the Thea rendering window. Clicking on it will bring back the dialog in case it was accidentally closed. The settings panel has 4 tabs. The display tab is used for post-processing with options for exposure, filtering, denoising, and more. The rendering tab has all the options for the Thea render engines, including device selection, clay render, and network rendering. In the channels tab, the user can enable the rendered channels that will be used for compositing, as well as set up special channels like denoise, depth, and photometric analysis. The last one is the animation tab with several options to produce animations supporting scene animation, Fredo's Animator, and others. The third icon opens the Thea browser window. Thea browser contains all the locally installed Thea materials, models, and skies. Additionally, you may also use the online repository that hosts thousands of materials. The Thea browser has tools to find missing textures, proxies, and environment maps, and also the options to save the SketchUp scene along with all the dependencies, making it easy to share a project. The last icon on the toolbar is the Thea rendering window. This window has anything related to rendering, setting up render settings, tone mapping, and more. You can start rendering in interactive mode in both viewport and the rendering window. To start interactive rendering in SketchUp window, you need to click on the IR button to enable interactive rendering and select the In SketchUp window display mode. Any one of these 4 display modes will make Thea for SketchUp to render interactively in SketchUp window with a different style. The first display mode in Thea window will start interactive rendering inside the Thea rendering window, which makes it convenient for multi-monitor setups. When it comes to producing the final image, we need to switch to production mode. This can be done by making sure that the interactive rendering switch is turned off. Clicking on the Start button will make the engine to render the final image based on the current settings like resolution, render engine, time and sample limits, render elements, and more. We will have a more detailed look on each one of these in other tutorials.
Thank you for watching.